Hi, welcome back to the channel. We're going to continue the Bandit Over the Wire series. I hope you've been enjoying the videos thus far. If this is your first time, welcome. We're going along from levels 20 to 24 today. And just while I'm talking about the levels, if you want to go back in a written form, I'm putting a long form content blog posts together, so if you want to read through and see screenshots and in a written version, that's being updated weekly as I'm going through. All right, with that out of the way, please leave a like if you find this useful, subscribe if you want to hang around, that would be awesome, and let's get into the video with level 20. We have our level goal here. To gain access to the next level, you should use the set UID binary in the home directory. Execute it without arguments to find out how to use it. The password with this level can be found in the usual place, etsy bandit underscore pass, after you have used the set UID binary. Let's have a little bit of a read for set UID. So short for set user identity or set group identity. It allows users to run an executable with the file system permissions of the executable's owner or group respectively, and to change behaviors of the directory. So let's run man set UID. So set user's identity. So there's not too many flags that we can run here. And looking back at that Wikipedia article, they often allow users on a computer system to run programs with temporarily elevated privileges in order to perform a specific task. Great, so got a little bit of a better understanding. We don't have the permissions to access this password, assumingly, so our set UID is gonna do that for us. So let's run LSLA and see what we're working with. We can see a bandit20.-do. Let's run file against it, and we've got a set UID executable. So again, going back to our instructions, it says execute it without arguments to find out how to use it. So let's go ahead and do that. Now we may need to run set UID with this, but let's just try and punch that in. All right, now let's try with set UID. So that command didn't work, but perhaps that we can just run it using our period slash to force it. We get run a command as another user. Example, dump in an ID. So if we run this and we put in the ID of the other user, we just need to find that ID. So if we run ID bandit 20, we've got 11020. So why don't we try and run that again, but now using bandit 20's ID? No luck. All right, making progress. I was actually super close. Just sort of playing around with it. I needed ID equals, so I just kept trying. And yeah, we got running the bandit20-do with the period in the forward slash, just ID equals the ID of the other user that we want. And now we can see that we've got the shell. So I'm gonna see if I can run that. And then I don't know if I need to pipe it or just run ls. Yeah, because it tells us where that we need to look. So if we cat this out, and then we know that there's a bunch of folders there. So bandit 20, and we got it. Awesome, let's save that off and hop into the next one. Alrighty, that brings us to level 21. Our goal here, there is a set UID binary in the home directory that does the following. It makes a connection to localhost on the port you specify as a command line argument. It then reads a line of text from the connection and compares it to the password in the previous level, bandit 20. If the password is correct, it will transmit the password for the next level. Ooh, okay, this one seems pretty tricky. We got more networking, so possibly SSH, Netcat, Bash, Screen, Tmux, Unix Job Control, background tasks, foreground tasks, running jobs. That's backgrounding tasks too. Okay, so yeah, got a few things going on here. So let's just have a quick LSLA. So it looks like this is gonna be our set UID to which it's talking about. And as it says, it makes a connection to the local host on the port you specify in a command line argument. Okay, so let's just see if we just try and run it as is. And we have got a helpful usage message. Put in a port number. Okay, so we're gonna send it the previous password onto whatever port, but we will need something to listen. because it's going to transmit it back. So, do we know a command that we can use that will listen? Anyone thinking NC, the Swiss Army knife? What if we ran it in listen mode for inbound connects? Let's give it a go. Dash L, and let's just put it on a random port number. So I've got this terminal open listening. So let's try this. Run this on this port, and can we go enter? Could not connect. Oh, whoops, a little bit silly. Make sure that you've got both of your terminals connected to the machine that you want to listen on. So you can't have your local machine while you're SSH'd into a remote machine. Expect them to be talking to each other. So let's try that again with the same. So we'll just do a practice run here so we can set up a listener. And then as you can see, I was just testing. So we can echo messages through and pipe that and send it through. So Netcat can send it through. And since this is listening on the other end, it's gonna grab whatever we set through. So if we leave this listening port, but instead echo through the previous password through this SUID, on the port that we want it to, and we get could not connect. Let's just make sure that that's up and running. So let's try it again, this time no echo, we'll just run it. We'll then paste in the flag and hit enter. So it didn't give me anything. Let's try paste it in on the listening, and would you look at that? So that's a little bit backwards in my head, because I thought we needed to send it through on this area, but we said passwords matches sending next password. Well, we got it, so we need to send it through on the listening side. Okay, cool. All right, I've just logged in and we're going over to level 22. Level goal, a program is running automatically at regular intervals from cron, the time-based job scheduler. Look in etcicron.d for the configuration and see what command is being executed. So just quickly looking up, so like I said, it's a job scheduler. I have used cron before, not in a big capacity, but it says here, it's all about automating maintenance or admin jobs, and we can... All right, so do we have anything directly in here? Doesn't look like it. Let's look in cron D with LSLA. It looks like we have a few cron job files here. Given that we are on level 22, I'm going to take it that we're going to look inside this one. Let's go ahead and cat that out. We've got at reboot, goes in the dull null. These are the time intervals, I assume, but since they're all stars, I'm not sure if that means anything at the moment. So it looks like this .sh file. Can we see anything about it? So if we cat this file out, you see it's got a shebang here, and it's gonna run from bash, change the permissions on this file, and then cat out this file and then redirect it to a temporary file. So if we look inside that temporary file. Okay, so it looks like it's just an ASCII text file and we can cat that out. So I assume that that is our password. Okay, let's see if we got it. Okay, that was it. Awesome. So it was just running that shell and just redirecting the output of a file into a temporary file. All right, moving over to level 23. The goal, a program is running automatically at regular intervals from cron, the time-based job scheduler that we just learned about. So we're gonna look back in that same directory we were in for the configuration file and see what command is being executed. Quick note, looking at the shell scripts written by other people is a very useful skill. The script for this level is intentionally made easy to read. If you have problems understanding what it does, try executing it and see the debug information it prints. So it's the same place that we listed out, but because we're over on 23, I'm gonna say this is what we're after. So let's go ahead and cat that file out. And we can see here it's using this shell script. Let's run file against it, just make sure it's just an ASCII text, but it's a shell executable. I mean, I didn't need to do that. It says what it is, but okay, just checking. All right, let's have a look. So it runs bin bash, my name, my target, echo. So this shell script, it's declaring variables. My name is equal to, is this gonna be the command, who am I? So the username, and then my target is going to execute echo im username, pipe that through md5 sum. So does that mean it's going to change, it's going to turn that into a hash, an md5 hash perhaps, and then pipe through the cut command and takes out all the spaces? Maybe, that's just my guess, I'm not really sure. Echo copying password file to password my name and then to temporary my target. Ooh, okay. All right, this is a little bit tricky. So I think I'm gonna take the notes hint here and try and run it myself and see what happens. Okay, so I've got the user name and then it made that hash, which I'm assuming is an MD5 hash. So can we just navigate to this directory? Or it's a file. Okay, it just made a file and then it put the password inside that file. No, because that's a password from level 21. So what we need to do is basically copy this, replace the my name variable with the user that we actually want, in this case Bandit23. That'll give us the hash that it would be making for Bandit23. So now if we ls temporary and that hash, hat rather, then we get the file, and we only know that because we put the hash through as 23, which is what it would be doing if you were logged in. So with that, assuming that this is then our flag. All right, logging in is 23, pasting it in, and we're in. Let's go. All right, now we're up to our last level for the video, level 24. Our program is running automatically at regular intervals from cron. So similar to last time, we got to look at there. Yep. And we got to figure out what's being used. This level requires you to create your own first shell script. This is a very big step and you should be proud of yourself when you beat this level. Aw, thank you. Note two, keep in mind that your shell script is removed once executed. So you may want to keep a copy around. All right, I'll just copy paste it. So let's do the same as last time and see what cron jobs we've got going. So because we're in level 24, let's grab that one. So let's cat that out and we've got user bin cron job bandit24 shell like the others. Let's go ahead and cat that out. And we've got our bin bash. All right, let's do some reading. Let's do some understanding. So we need to start our shell scripts with this. And this one's gonna again get the username. Then it's gonna change directories into this directory, echoing, executing, deleting all scripts in here. And then it does a for loop for I in anything.anything. So do this. If the variable I, so this is iterating through each item. So if the current item is not equal to, right, so the current period or the directory above, so as long as it's not equal to this and it's not equal to this, then do the following. All right, so it's basically deleting everything else. Echo handling current directory owner, so it's creating another variable owner, which is then running the command stat dash dash format, you're not sure about that, and then the current iterated file. So I can see that by current place forward slash and then the iterated item. So there's a condition though, if the owner, so I guess this is grabbing the owner of the file. Okay, and then it's checking if this owner is equal to bandit23, then timeout, finish. So if this condition is not met, then it removes the iterated file. It finishes and then it's done. Whew, this is tricky. Okay, this is pretty tricky. Okay, so let's just let that simmer. All right, let's just highlight it all and make our own. Make directory in our temporary CD over there. And then let's open our newly found shell scripts. I'm going in the wrong direction because this is saying if the owner is us, timeout, wait 60 seconds, I think, and then execute the file. So it's going to create executing and then deleting all the scripts. So this is what I missed. It's executing. Okay. So if we can put something in here that then gets executed, if it's owned by us, it'll be executed when it iterates through. Okay, I missed that. So we're not creating some sort of version of this. Instead, we want to create something that will be executed. So remember, the passwords are stored in etsy bandit pass. So here's our password in here, right? But we don't have permissions to touch it. But if that shell script has the permissions to touch it, why can't we write a script that'll be executed on the system to cat that out? But then we want to pipe it through or redirect it to our folder that we created and then just create like a text file or something. So then the only thing we need to do once we've got sort of like the payload, we then just need to get it on the area that it's going to be executed from. Just to be safe, let's give it full 7.7 permissions. So let's just copy our newfound shell script, but we want to put it in this area that's going to be executed from. So var spool bandit24-foo. And now we wait. Okay, it's been over a minute, and I've had a little bit of time to ponder, and I think I know what I did wrong. Okay, so if we actually just try and make that password file, but this time we give everyone read and write access to it. And we just double check our file is indeed going to cat it out and then redirect or write it to our password.txt. And lastly, let's just make sure everyone has the right to execute. Then we just move our cron file over into the bandit24-foo folder. And then after we wait a little bit, we will see there are some bytes. And if we cat out our password, it has put it in there. Wow, that was hard. So just to make sure that we've got it, let's just check that it's working. And we've got into the next level. Awesome. Thank you so much for checking out this video. I hope you found it useful. That last one got really hard. So that was fun that we could do that together. I learned a lot. So it's been pretty good going through and doing these levels. If you like this video, please do leave a like. If you loved it, consider subscribing. And if you have any feedback for how I've gone through, if I haven't explained things well enough, please let me know. Leave a comment and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. But yeah, that's been Bandit level 2224. So thank you very much again. And I'll see you in the next one for the next 5 levels.